Do you guys ever think about this? Because this is something Allah is telling us in the Quran to think about. That look at these things, that no matter how beautiful the flower is, it only lasts for a limited amount of time. And over time, no matter how beautiful it started, come 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks, what does it do? It wilts, and then it dries up, and you can, at some point, you can just take it in your hand and just crumble it. It's nothing. And it just, you could, it just blows in the wind. This is, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, this is the example of this life. This life is just like that plant, just like that garden. That for a while, it's very beautiful and you feel very happy about it, but then it withers away. And what's left, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say is left? Either Jannah or Jahannam. That's what's left. So this is how we have to understand this life. And we need to seek, like look at around the signs around us, they teach us about these things, that nothing here lasts. Another example is our youth. Like you guys, you don't feel this because you are all young right now. Yeah? But if I were talking to a room of 60-year-olds, 70-year-olds, they would feel what I was saying. Like, I was young like yesterday, man. Where did it go? But even if you think about when you were in middle school, it doesn't seem like it was that far away. The point is that no matter how, you know, how youthful someone is or how beautiful someone is in their at some point in their life, what happens? Take the most attractive superstar, or I mean movie star. But what happens after 10, 20, 30 years to them? Nobody, no matter how much plastic surgery they, you know, try to, you know, to do, nobody will look the same. Over time, you lose that beauty. And this is the sunnah of this life, that everything passes away, except for one thing, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only thing that's lasting. So what we have to do is be careful not to hold on to what's passing away. And we need to hold on to what's lasting. And we need to prepare for what's lasting. Because it's just a foolish person who sits and puts all of the furniture. You know, it's like, imagine that you know that you're moving to another house. And you sit and you take all the furniture from that house you're moving into and you put it in your dorm that you're leaving. It wouldn't make any logical sense, right? What we do, we take from our akhirah, the house that we're going to, and we fill our dunya, which is the house we're leaving, the dorm that we're leaving. We need to really just not, that's a foolish thing to do, because we know that we're leaving this life and we're going to the next. So furnish the next life, because that's the life you're going to, and that's the one that lasts. Okay, so I'm going to, inshallah, go through, this is what I would say, so 10-step recipe for success, inshallah, in this path to our final home, inshallah. The first one is what I talked about for a little bit, and that is know what your goal is. You need to know where you're going. If you're in a race and you don't know where you're going, you're never gonna get there. You need to know what your goal is. It has to be very clear in your mind. And in our here, the goal is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So know Allah, know who Allah is, know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from you.